Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/APOD. And today's picture for April the 19th of 2020, well, it is titled Cassini Approaches Saturn. So what do we see here? Well, this is a video clip that we're going to take a look at, and it shows the approach to Saturn of Cassini back well over a decade ago. Now, the Cassini spacecraft spent a long time, more than a decade, orbiting Saturn and studying the giant planet and its moons. And in 2017, when it was running low on fuel, it was directed to crash into the planet itself. Well, not so much crash into the planet as to enter its atmosphere, which would have caused it to be vaporized. So the intense heat and pressures as it went into the atmosphere would have destroyed the spacecraft. So when we play the video, and yes, you will start about a minute into the video, so you're ignoring the first minute, it will start you automatically about a minute in. And as you play the video, you see the beginning approach as Saturn is there off in the distance with its majestic rings. And we can see some of the details in Saturn's atmosphere, not near as prominent as what we see with Jupiter, for example, but because Saturn is much colder, further away from the sun, so all of its cloud layers are deeper down in the atmosphere, so we're looking at them through a haze. Now, as we see the ring system, we can see brighter and darker areas where we see more and fewer ring particles, and we can see that the rings are very thin as we pass the ring plane. In fact, they're thinner than a piece of paper to scale, and that is the structures that we see are all caused by the moons of Saturn. So all of the detailed lines and structures that we see on Saturn are all caused by its moons. And the gaps are caused by gravitational interactions between the moons and the ring particles, clearing out some of those regions and causing concentrations in other areas. So we can see those dark and light bands as we move through the image. Now, we're going to look at this a second time. I talked a little bit about Saturn and its rings in the first pass, but I'm going to play it again here in just a moment, and that will allow us to look at and talk a little bit about the moons. So it was kind of a short video clip, not enough time to really talk about the rings and the moons together, but as we play it again, we note that there are several moons of Saturn visible. Now, the one down below and to the left of Saturn is its large moon, Titan. Titan is the only moon in the solar system with a significant atmosphere. It is also the only moon we have landed on in the outer solar system at this point. Now, as we move in through the ring plane again, another moon comes into view. This is Mimas, sometimes known as the Death Star moon for its large crater that you'll see here in the upper right-hand side as it comes in. Very large impact that occurred on this moon long ago. And then we're seeing again, as we saw last time, we're going to see the rings of Saturn as we pass through the ring plane again. And you can actually consider really each of the rings of ring particles of Saturn is an individual moon orbiting around Saturn itself. So they're not a solid sheet, but are a number of billions and billions of ring particles. Now we see one more moon off in the distance. This is Enceladus. And as we approach that, it is one that actually has liquid water below its surface. Water is actually geysered out below from the polar regions due to interactions. So the moons of Saturn are a very diverse group that we see that have some very interesting properties, from atmospheres to liquid water to great impacts, and all a little bit different, and each of them telling us a little bit about the Saturnian system that we at Cassini was able to study for well over a decade. So that was our picture of the day for April the 19th of 2020. It was titled Cassini Approaches Saturn. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Space Chicken. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.